Hello everyone. So today I am going to explain you how to do double stub matching circuit using Smith chart. So when matching is required, if there will be mismatch at the load end, there will be mismatch at input end also. So to avoid incoming power to reflect back, we can use matching network. So there are various type of matching network. One is single stub matching, another one is double stub matching network. So in this matching, the distance between two stub will be fixed, whether it is lambda by 8, lambda by 4, or any given distance between the stub. So in this particular problem, I have taken two stubs which is separated by lambda by 8 distance, and the load impedance is given by 60 plus 40 j ohm. This is the first stub, number 1, and this is the second stub, and the line impedance of this is Z naught, which is given by 50 ohm. In this case, it is 50 ohm. So the first step for any matching network is to normalize the load impedance. So if load impedance 60 plus 40 j ohm, the normalized value will be equal to 1.2 plus 0.8 j. Then identify this load point on the Smith chart. So it will be 1.2, resistance circle is here, and 0.8j reactance circle is here. So the cutting point of these two will be the load impedance. So this one is our load impedance. So we'll draw a line which is passing through the center to the outside boundary of the Smith chart. So we can draw line using pencil, because this line will not be required. Now we have to extend this line in opposite direction. So this one will be the opposite direction line, which is 180 degree from this one, this point. So again, we have to identify the load admittance for this. What we will do? We will take the distance from the center, this measured with the compass, and then cut this side. So the cutting point is going to be this one, which is YL, is load admittance. Now this is the load admittance, and the first stub is directly connected here, and this stub is short circuited. So it is going to give you only reactive value. That means whatever is the real part of this admittance is not going to change. Only the imaginary part will change. So if I write this YL from here, we can read it. It is 0.57 plus minus 0.4j. So next step is, which is very important step, to draw this 1 plus JB circle lambda by 8 from the original JB, 1 plus JB circle. So for that purpose, what we are going to do, we have to take the radius of this 1 plus JB circle. The radius of 1 plus JB circle will be this. The point 3.0 will be the center for the 1 plus JB circle. So this we can use as radius. So you can see from the center to 0.3 and 0.3 to the outer boundary, it is almost same. Now we have to move by lambda by 8. This is lambda by 8. So original circle is at lambda by at 0.25 lambda. So we are going to move by lambda by 8 in opposite direction. For that we have to find the point that is equal to 0.125 lambda. So this point is 0.125 lambda. We can draw line and then take the center and draw a circle. So this circle we are going to draw. This is called rotated 1 plus JB circle. Make sure that this circle passes through this point, that is the outer boundary of the Smith chart, as well as the center of the Smith chart. So that will be your correct 1 plus JB circle. Now you start moving on the constant resistance here. This is constant resistance, and this, if you move, you will get this point, stopping point number one. Another point will be, if you keep moving, you will go to the other side of the circle. So this line divides this rotated circle in two parts, first part and the second part. So you will be reaching in the first part, and if you keep moving, you will reaching on the second part. So both the parts will give you two solution. We'll take the first part, this one, and we'll read what is the value. In fact, this value is very, very less. It's near about 0.6. So we can write the value. At this point, it is 0.57 plus J 0.006. So the susceptance contributed by first stub is this admittance minus this admittance. This was the initial admittance. Now, because of the first stub, it is changed to this one. So we can write 0.006 minus, in fact it is 0.06. Not 006. So 0.06 minus 0.4 J. So it will become plus J 0.46. So we'll keep this for, this value will keep for finding the length. Corresponding length we have to find from here. Now next, this is JB1, so susceptance contributed by the first stub is J0.46. Now what you have to do? We have to take the radius of this point. So this radius we have to take. We have reached at this point. If you can see this point, and then we have to make a circle which will go to the 1 plus JB circle. So basically this movement was on the stub itself, the stub. We are moving from YL to the 1 plus JB circle. Now we are going to move on original 1 plus JB circle by taking a constant VSWR circle. So this is constant VSWR circle. From first stub to the second stub, this will be constant VSWR circle. And if you read the value, it is around 1 plus, this value is 1 plus J is a bit less than 0.6 and more than 0.55. So I will consider this as 0.57. So it is 1 plus J 0.57. So the susceptance contributed by the second stub will be minus J 0.57, so that it will become 1 plus J 0. So I can write JB2 equal to minus J 0.57. This is going to give you L2. Obviously we are using short circuited, so we are going to find length for the short circuited. So you have the two susceptance for these two stubs. Now we have to find the length. So for the first stub, J 0.46, so you have to find on the outer boundary where is plus J 0.46. it will be somewhere here. So this point is J 0.46. so we are going to find the corresponding length here. I'll just highlight this point here. This is J 0.46, and what is the value of wavelength to watt generator? It is 0.068 lambda. That is 0.068 lambda, and the starting point is 0.25 lambda, which is a short circuit end. So if I start from here, complete the half circle here, it will become 0.5 lambda plus 0.068 lambda. So you can write 0.25 lambda, that is from this point to this point, plus 0.068 lambda, plus 0.068 lambda, which will give you the L1 equals 0.318 lambda, 318 lambda. Similarly, we can calculate for the second one. Second one is minus J 0.57. so minus J 0.57 is here. If I extend this from the center, you'll be getting 0.412414416. so this point is 0.416 lambda. Is 0.416 lambda. So from 0.416 lambda, 0.25 lambda is starting, so we have to take the difference of these two. So I can write 0.416 lambda minus 0.25 lambda, which is equal to 6.61. So L2 is 0.166 lambda. So this is one of the solutions. So first stub length should be 0.318 lambda, and second stub length should be 0.166 lambda. Now for example, if the frequency is given, the operating frequency is given for this particular network, then L1 can be calculated in centimeter or millimeter, because we can calculate from given frequency, we can calculate the wavelength. And if the dielectric constant is given, then also we can calculate the lambda. So always remember, if you have to calculate lambda, use Vp by F as the formula. If it is free space, Vp will be C. If it is dielectric material, Vp will be less than C. That you have to calculate, and frequency is given. So accordingly, we can calculate lambda in centimeter or millimeter, and then multiply here with lambda, 0.318 into lambda, and 0.166 lambda, 0.166 into lambda, you will get the length in centimeter or millimeter. So this is all about doing double stub matching. So you'll be seeing in next video, we'll be seeing the quarter wave matching. Thank you.